Hello, my lovely people of the crafting universe. Today we are unboxing the Papercraft Society's box number 11, into 11. And at the end you will see something that I made from the contents of the box. So, as always, we have the box signed by the designer. This time it's Christina Griffiths. And we have the folder. We have the secret packet. And we have a voucher for shopping on the Craft Stash site. So let's put the box aside and let's start with the folder. So let's see what's inside. Let's open it. 1, 2, and 3. And so we see that we have dies. This time we have a very practical advice from the designer for written on the box instead of just a motivational quote. So for example, on the dies box you saw the designer advised us to cut up the cut dies to get a different design. And let's go to the stamps. So we have flowers, we have leaves, we have berries. Oh, this is beautiful. These are some autumn berries, but I guess they can be strawberries, raspberries, whatever berry you want it to be, depending on coloring. We have corn, leaves, and quotes which are suited for Thanksgiving even, like autumn harvest quotes. There is a quote that says, "With love, sending wishes your way, thanks for everything, simply thankful for all God's things, and even a very useful on your birthday quote." So very versatile stamp set. And now on to dies. So we have this big, gorgeous aperture die, which casts like leafy vines. And then we have leaves and flowers. And let's check if the dies go with the stamps. And yes, there are dies for the flower stamps, for the bigger and the smaller flower. Yeah, there is die for the leaf also. Yes, that's for the smaller flower. A die for the leaf. And this die, which is for the corn. No, it doesn't go with a stamp. It is bigger than the stamp. Maybe it would be interesting to try if you can make like a shadow behind it with the die. Interesting. There is a die for the leaf. One more flower die. And most importantly, that's a die for the berries. And most importantly, there is a die for the berry stem. Yay! And you will see the dies in action after the unboxing when I will make something. You will also see the gorgeous big aperture die. So let's see what else is in the box. Papers! Ooh! 2 packs of papers. Okay. With which one shall we start? Let's start with the pattern paper. Now we are beginning to see the colors of the kit. And there are cut lines on the back of the paper. So intriguing, intriguing. What's going to be there? So these are the colors, like orangey, greeny, but very light. Not your usual rich autumn colors. So very interesting. This is a one-sided paper. It's not very thick. It looks like 120 gram paper, maybe. Even a paler paper. There is a touch of shimmer to this paper. Green leaves, orange. Ooh! And this. Oh, if you are a card maker, you will love this. These are. No, those are not stickers. Those are toppers that you can put on top of your card to enhance it. And we get two sheets, and those are not the same sheets. So every little topper is different. I especially like those two little ones, which I think could be used like a bottle etiquettes, for example. And then there are two colors of gold cardstock. Single-sided cardstock, the rose gold and more usual gold. And it has a little texture in them. So those are the papers. And let's open the very secretive package. The packet, as always, enwrapped in generous amounts of tissue paper. This time it's bright orange. And I never throw out the tissue paper. It sometimes is useful when you create something. So, what is in the packet? Let's remove the tissue paper to have a better look at all the goodies here. And I'm very happy to see the inks. For the last two boxes, I think we didn't have inks. We had other coloring mediums, but now the inks have returned, and I'm very happy for that. These are hybrid inks, so you can use them with watercolors, you can use them with alcohol markers, and just looking at these inks, don't they give you some Halloweenish vibes? This kit is beginning to look more and more interesting. It's not your traditional autumn kit. It's walking, I think, the edge between Halloween and autumn. Very, very interesting. I think Christina has found some really interesting color combinations here. So we have a satin ribbon, about a centimeter wide, and a packet of wooden buttons, and a packet of doilies. I know that a lot of card makers and a lot of mixed media artists like them. To be honest, they have not found their way into my heart. Maybe I just don't know really well how to use them, but there is a very generous packet. A lot of them. So if you are a card maker, you will love this. And as always, there is the piece of card which gives you a good advice. This time it's about different tapes. So you can collect them. I know that my crafting friends collect these, but I would also use this as a base to create a tag maybe, or another mixed media project. And then there is the booklet. There is an interview with the designer. There is description of the products. There is description of the new products by Craft Stash. There is a lot of inspiration. You will even see a very interesting use of the doilies. So that was a discovery for me, that the doilies can be really interesting. So having this booklet is like having a whole new crafting magazine. And so this was the kit all together, and let's see what we can make from it. And the colors really spoke to me, so I've decided to try an art journal page, just to see if I can make an art journal page from a kit which is very card-orientated. So I chose several papers from my stash, which go together with the color scheme of this kit, like light blue, grayish blues and greens and reds. And I'm gluing them down using a very liquid gel medium. Liquid gel medium in this case is okay because the papers are very thick. So the medium will not soak into the paper and will not make them wrinkle very much. So this is the paper from the kit, which I'm using on the foreground of my page, and another paper from the kit, just to have the lighter colors in front and to have the bluish colors for the top part, which I'm seeing as a sky, and the beautiful green paper from the kit. I'm not cutting the paper, I'm just tearing the pieces and gluing them quite randomly, just thinking about the sky part and the earth part of the page. While that's drying, I'm using the papers from the kit to roughly cut the tree shapes. Nothing precise there, I didn't even draw them first, just using scissors and cutting some tree shapes and gluing them down with the liquid gel medium. Tinier shapes in the background, bigger shapes in the foreground. So to me the middle part sort of starts looking like a water maybe. We'll see how it works. And while I was gluing the trees, I suddenly realized, hey, but I have the orange paper, so I could use it to make sunset. I really wanted to have some brighter sunset illusion on my sky. So the orange tissue paper, just perfect for that. So I'm gluing the tissue paper on top. It will become less visible when dry, because when you add the glue, it makes tissue paper even more transparent as it is. I'm really happy with this, and I'm adding several layers of the tissue paper where my horizon line is to make it even brighter there. And then just some tiny little pieces of the orange tissue paper on the ground part to echo the sunset or have some sunsety lights playing. You know what I mean. So while that was drying, I went on to die cutting, and this is the aperture die. It works really well, it's very intricate, but I had to run it through the die cutting machine just once, and all the little tiny pieces dropped out, and I'm tearing it apart because I don't need the circle. I want the leaves to be the background for my plants and berries. So I'm tearing it apart, and I'm quite happy that in the spirit of Halloween, some parts even tore out looking like spiders. So that's interesting. I'm leaving them there. And then I'm using the papers included in the kit, not exactly to paper piece the berries, but to cut them, die cuts apart, and glue them together back on the base I got from the red cardstock. I did stamp the berries also, but it was just to guide me where the stems are, where the berries are, where the flowers are. They do not look much at the moment, but I will color them later. And now let's return to the art journal itself, and let's make some shadows. And I'm using the bluish ink included in the kit to create shadows around my paper pieces. I pressed the ink on my glass mat, and then using a brush dipped in water, I'm drawing shadowy lines around the paper pieces. And that's interesting because the ink looks blue, but if you look closer, you see that it has a reddish tint in it. so it turned out like a purple shadow. Quite happy, goes well with the Halloween theme. And while the inks are out, I'm coloring the berries and the leaves. So I'm using the orange ink for the berries. With the same principle, first pressing the ink on my glass mat and then using a brush to pick it up. And just because there is still ink left on my glass mat, not to waste it, I'm touching with it the other parts of the die cuts. So the green goes on the leaves. Let's be very traditional here. And then it's time to glue everything on the page. So the black leaves, the vines, go in the background, and on top the die cut with berries and flowers and leaves. And this time I'm switching the gel medium, and I'm choosing a very heavy gel medium because the die cut pieces are quite heavy. There are several layers cut from quite thick paper, so it needs some more serious glue to glue them to the background. And I'm covering also the surface of the die cuts with a gel medium. So the last piece of the black background vines going in, and the orange berries for some accents. I didn't use all my die cuts, I thought that we have enough leaves. So when that was done, I went around all the paper pieces with a black charcoal pencil to enhance the border. And now to add some highlights, I'm using white gel pen. I painted in the berries. I went around the leaves, the flowers in the foreground. And I'm enhancing the trees that are closer to the foreground, also using the white gel pen. And I'm quite happy with the result. So this is what happens if you try to use a card kit to make an art journal page. So now all it's left is to arrange the inks, and I'm leaving you with the still images of the art journal page. And if you look in the description section, I will leave a link there where you can go and leave your email if you want to receive free digital downloads on which I'm currently working on. So I hope you enjoyed this art journal page, and see you soon. Bye bye.